Using structural equation model to reveal factors affecting faculty members in university colleges and the use of Moodle. This article is written by three authors. First author Omar M. Mahanan. Second author Haroon M. Dawara. Last author Hussein A. Alawama. Contribution and originality of the study is that this study is one of very few studies which have investigated structural equation model, SEM, to reveal the factors affecting the use of faculty members in university colleges for the e-learning system, Moodle. This study represents a guide for universities on providing all facilities for faculty to improve their efficiency in using the e-learning system, Moodle. The current study aimed at using the structural equation modeling, SEM, to detect the factors affecting the role of faculty members in university colleges for e-learning system, Moodle. The study has used the descriptive approach through the questionnaire tool which consisted in its final form of 33 items distributed on 10 factors. The study sample consisted of 487 faculty members in university colleges. The AMIS program was used to analyze the data using the structural equation modeling, SEM, through the path analysis method and goodness of fit tests to test the validity of the proposed model. The results of the study identified 6 factors that affect the use of faculty members for the e-learning system model in the teaching process, viz., the competence of faculty members, the efficiency of the e-learning system, training benefits, the influence of others, and facilities. In addition, 3 factors were identified as outputs for the use of the faculty e-learning system, namely quality of teaching, faculty satisfaction, and faculty confidence in the e-learning system. The study recommends educational policymakers in the Ministry of Higher Education, Scientific Research and University Administration to adopt these factors identified in this study and implement the effect of these factors on the use of faculty members for the e-learning system, Moodle, in order to achieve learning outcomes for academic programs. Thanks for watching this video of International Journal of Education and Practice Volume 9 Issue Number 1.